Hi. So we discussed previously what are the criteria when you want to choose a CMS. So now maybe it's time to look at the different options for
Yeah.
when it comes to a CMS.
And detail the actual decision of choosing a CMS,
Yes.
right? So first, well, it depends what you're trying to achieve, right? So if you want to get out on the wild world wide web and just blog and talk, well, just take Medium or Ghost, or well, Medium is the best maybe there, right? You want to write, you don't care about a certain style or certain it's pretty proper, it gives you a lot of options.
And people can find you easily. When they
People
look
can
at
find it
Medium, they
easily,
know
they
you.
have that kind of the network, so that's a very good choice. That's the best choice for these kind of cases. Now, of course, if your blog wants you want the design to be custom, you want to add your own
Style.
components inside, or style or whatever, then you need to go to custom, right? Now, I would go, it depends. Like, of course, there's the WYSIWYG approach. You can go to something like, I don't know, Wix or all these kind of things, Squarespace, where you have like themes or an interface where you can build
Mix
your
and match different
website
blocks.
without even coding. That may be a choice if you don't have the skills, or you don't want to learn, or you don't have someone that can do that for you. And then whenever you want something even more custom than that, so you don't want your website to look like others' website, you want to have your unique experience you can deliver to your clients or your users or your audience, some unique experience, well, you need to go coding, right?
Yes.
Now, of course, you can go take some theme from a framework or from a CMS like WordPress and deploy that. That can get you something maybe a bit more personalized, but still, it's a theme that anyone can use, and anyone can
Yes.
get into that. And the problem with WordPress is that there's a complexity of plugins that is very hard to maintain, very hard to manage.
And you need to know a bit about PHP if you're a
Of
JavaScript
course, you need
developer.
to know a bit about PHP and development. So now, if you are Imagine you have already something, and you're trying to improve it. You add more pages, add more sections, and you are already on WordPress. Well, one thing you can do is you can go use an API and use WordPress through an API. This way, you can use your framework of choice. We talked about in a video about the different technologies that you could use. So you
Yeah.
can use WordPress as just the content management, and you use their API.
But in that case,
But in that case, you will not get any
yes.
the plugins. You will not be able to use the plugins that you have, and it's the whole experience is not. It wasn't meant to be. The API was added afterwards, so maybe it will
That's
not be a great
optimized for
experience.
it.
Yeah, not optimized. So in that case, I would go right for a headless CMS.
Okay.
Now, in the offer of Headless CMS, there are so many things, right? So I would just first focus on something that has a community, so people are like that are doing with it. Then you know that you're not alone. You know that other people might be asking the same thing as you.
That they have like a similar project so they can help you out during the
Yeah,
implementation.
right.
Yeah.
These kind of things, and I will go also for something that has very good performance, because when you do go the API approach, you want the API to be very quick, very performant.
Okay.
Something that has a CDN, so that you whatever your user is, well, they get a good experience. That's especially for images. So that's how I would choose like a headless CMS. And then of course you need to go for if you are using component approach. Well, for instance, in Prismic we provide slices that allow you to do that. So you need a CMS that headless CMS that allows you to have this kind of component approach,
But
right?
at some point, you need to try different options.
Yeah,
Like, it's not really
I think
about
this.
features, it's more about the experience. So, you need,
Yeah,
anyways, to try things.
that's what you're saying. I like it. Like, it's about the developer experience. You need to be productive to like the thing. So what I find, I encourage like our customers. They do a lot of this. They go testing different things. They do POCs. I
Yes.
encourage this approach. I will not tell them, no, use Prismic and don't do your POCs. Do your POCs. And take what you feel for you, because by the end of the day you'll end up using this thing a lot, and that's why the proof of concept, the small project that you do, allows you to explore the experience of building this thing, and then you choose for yourself, and then you know what you're choosing. So it's an important thing to test things out before, and everyone of these CMSs will have some kind of
Samples.
free tire or something like this, use that, do the project, small project, and then, you know, decide for yourself.
Okay, cool.